Hey guys, let's get more news about Dallas, but first, don't forget to subscribe and leave your like. Ex-Steelers, Cowboys receiver attempting NFL comeback, I still have it. Former Pittsburgh Steelers and Dallas Cowboys wide receiver James Washington is attempting an NFL comeback after not having played in the league since 2022. Washington, 28, most recently played for the Cowboys in 2022, but suffered a Jones fracture in his right foot during team training camp and underwent surgery. He returned to the Cowboys in December of that season, registering just one target and zero catches in two games played. His stint in Dallas followed four seasons with the Steelers from 2018 to 2021, where the former second-round pick recorded 114 receptions for 1,629 yards and 11 touchdowns in 60 games played, including 25 starts. Washington, a former standout at Oklahoma State, signed with the New Orleans Saints in May 2023, but was released in August. He was then signed by the Indianapolis Colts, but was released again in late August before the season began. "I was forgotten about, and I want to show the world I still have it," Washington said in an Instagram video. "People say, he's done, he's washed. There's still a lot of meat left on the bone. Physical-wise, conditioning-wise, I'm stronger than ever. I train 5 days a week, and the other 2 days of the week I'm thinking about it. Injuries happen. It's not about how you handle it, it's about how you come back," he added. Washington has received multiple inquiries from NFL teams and could be participating in tryouts soon, according to ESPN's Jeremy Fowler. Former NFL GM questions Cowboys about Dak Prescott contract situation. The Dallas Cowboys might be playing a dangerous game right now. Jerry Jones promised he would go all in during the offseason, but that wasn't the case. On top of that, he didn't even get Dak Prescott the contract extension he was looking for, and he could now become a free agent at the end of the season. With that in mind, former NFL GM Rick Spielman questioned Jones' operations, particularly their handling of Prescott's contract situation. Talking on SiriusXM NFL Radio, he claimed that he just doesn't understand the holdup with this contract, as they should get the deal done if they truly believe Prescott is their guy. He stated that perhaps we all misunderstood what Jones said about going all in, and maybe he wanted to say that he would make a final push with this roster before blowing it all up, including the coaching staff. Spielman added that it's most likely that Prescott will get his market value in free agency, as he was an MVP candidate just last season and has a proven record in this league, so he shouldn't find much trouble getting plenty of offers on his table. Jerry Jones has done an outstanding job of making the Cowboys a lot of money, but not so much at getting them wins. Now, he's playing with fire and could either lose his franchise quarterback or pay more money than it would have cost him in the first place if they had just signed him already. Cowboys predicted to make deadline blockbuster trade featuring Dak Prescott. A bold scenario would see the Dallas Cowboys deal Dak Prescott at the trade deadline during the 2024 season. As part of a series of bold predictions from Bleacher Report's Brad Gagnon, one of the scenarios would see the Cowboys unload Prescott to a team desperate for a quarterback. Quarterbacks rarely move in the middle of seasons, but most of the ingredients are there in this case, Gagnon wrote on June 21. Now, if a contender were to suffer a major injury at quarterback, or if a team like Las Vegas or Seattle finds itself in contention in spite of what it has at quarterback, a deadline blockbuster involving Prescott could come to fruition. Gagnon noted that the scenario is predicated Dallas falling out of contention. Gagnon mentions the Philadelphia Eagles as the clear favorite in the NFC East, potentially leading to the Cowboys deciding to move the three-time Pro Bowl quarterback as he goes through the final season of his contract. The Cowboys and Prescott are embroiled in a contract impasse. While Dallas remains adamant that they want to get a long-term deal done with their franchise quarterback, there has been little traction in contract talks. That's not even mentioning how the Cowboys still have to get long-term deals done with CeeDee Lamb and Micah Parsons. As Gagnon mentions, Prescott's lack of postseason success, he's 2-5 in the playoffs and has never advanced past the divisional round, may play a major role in the Cowboys deciding to move on from the 30-year-old quarterback. And if that happens, the organization could very well decide it's time to move on from Prescott, who has been part of just 2 playoff wins and has thrown 4 interceptions in the team's last 2 postseason losses, writes Gagnon. There's little doubt that Prescott will garner a big money deal if he were to enter the free agency market. According to SpotTrack, his projected market value is $53.1 million per year across 4 years for a total of over $212 million. That would make Prescott the second highest paid quarterback in the NFL. Considering Kirk Cousins, a quarterback who is even older than Prescott and has just 1 career playoff win to his name, just signed a 4-year, $180 million contract with the Atlanta Falcons after coming off an Achilles tear, Prescott, who finished as the runner-up in MVP voting during the 2023 season, will likely sign an even bigger deal if he were to enter free agency in 2025. If the Cowboys don't want to pay Prescott north of $50 million per year, dealing him to a team such as the Seahawks could be beneficial for both sides. Although Seattle is technically an NFC contender, they could package draft assets along with potential veteran pieces to sweeten the deal for Dallas. The Seahawks currently feature Geno Smith as their starting quarterback, but he has never won a playoff game in his career. And although he has played in the Pro Bowl over the past 2 seasons, he has never proven to be a consistent winning quarterback during his 11 seasons in the NFL. In fact, prior to the 2022 season, Smith had not served as a full-time starting quarterback since the 2014 season. Smith's numbers declined across the board in 2023 compared to his comeback player of the year season in 2022. With a new regime, head coach Mike McDonald and offensive coordinator Ryan Grubb are entering their first years in Seattle, Smith's hold on the starting quarterback job may not be very strong. Considering the Seahawks already have one of the better offensive supporting casts in the league with 3 legit receivers, DK Metcalf, Tyler Lockett and Jackson Smith-Njigba, and a productive running back duo in Kenneth Walker and Zach Charbonnet, Prescott may be the missing piece to lift the Seahawks over the top. The Dallas Cowboys and Dak Prescott may very well ride into the sunset together with a lucrative new contract extension. It would not be the first time Prescott and the Cowboys had a lengthy negotiating period that eventually was resolved. Yet, Prescott has also emphasized that he has control over his future. This is especially true thanks to a no-franchise tag clause as well as a no-trade option in his current deal. All this means that Prescott could become a free agent in 2025, with Dallas receiving nothing in return. This is a less than ideal option for the Cowboys, especially given the alternative veteran quarterback options. ESPN's Bill Barnwell labeled Kirk Cousins and Derek Carr as potential veteran replacement starters for Dallas to consider in 2025. And you, fan? What do you think of the situation of Dak Prescott? Leave your opinion in the comments.